Our QuickBooks file is now ready to receive transactions. Now you may well ask, what is a transaction? Well, for our purposes in this set of videos, a transaction is an event. A transaction is a moment in time where our company buys or sells a product or service. Now that is a very limited definition because our introductory videos are very basic. If you study a little more accounting, you will learn that the event of borrowing money is actually a transaction, and the moment that you make a payment to pay back the money is also a transaction. If you think about this, this will give you some idea about what a transaction is. When we experience a transaction, we need proof. We need some kind of physical proof that the event happened. So each different kind of transaction needs a different document as proof. For example, if we made a cash sale, we would physically give the customer a sale receipt, and the sale receipt would be the proof of that transaction. If we give a customer a service, and at the moment we give the service, the customer only promises to pay, well, in that case, we would give an invoice or a bill. If we give a service, the customer owes us money, and therefore that's a transaction, and the proof of that transaction would be the invoice or bill the customer signs. If we deposit money in a bank, that's a transaction. The proof of that transaction is the document called a deposit slip. If we pay money directly from the bank account and give it to someone, the proof of that transaction is a check. All of these documents that prove a transaction actually happened have a special name. These documents are called source documents. They are called source documents because they are the first place that the information about the transaction is recorded on. Every source document has the same fields of information that are on every single transaction. Every single transaction has a date when the event happened. Every single transaction has a person or a company involved in the transaction. Every transaction has an item of product or service that's being sold or purchased. And every transaction has a money amount. These are all things that must be written on the document, regardless of what type of transaction or regardless of what type of document you're making as proof of the transaction. Every source document must have a unique specific number that identifies that document and identifies that transaction. Many of you have seen invoices before. You notice that it says invoice number 3, invoice number 10. Many of you have seen checks before, and in the top right corner of the check, it says check number 60, check number 70. If you did the transaction, then you might not have a physical document, but every transaction, whether it's online or done with a document, has a unique specific number that identifies the transaction. Usually, if you pay online or get paid online, the merchant service or the customer gives you a confirmation number to make sure that you can identify that specific transaction. The confirmation number is the number that would go into the field of the document, like check number or invoice number. Some people like to take a screenshot, push print screen, and take a picture of the screen when the confirmation number is displayed. Then they print that picture and file it as the source document for that transaction. In our company, it's going to be much more simple than that. When you record a transaction in QuickBooks, you open up a window that looks like the source document for that transaction. For example, if you have to write a check, you would open up a window in QuickBooks that looks like a check. If you made a deposit and you want to record the deposit in QuickBooks, you would open up a window in the computer that looks like a deposit slip. Regardless of the transaction type and regardless of the source document, every time you record a transaction, there will be a field in the window for the date. Every time you record a different type of transaction, there will be a field to tell QuickBooks who is the other person or company involved in the transaction. There will always be a space in any source document and in any window for transactions in QuickBooks to record the money amount. That's what the windows look like when you record the transactions, and QuickBooks knows what information will be there because it will be the same information for every transaction. In our example company, it will be even easier to record transactions. In our example company, we will record all of our transactions in this window. This window is called the register window. We can record both bank deposits and check payments to vendors here in this very same window. Not all companies are able to use this window. Our company is able to use this window because we only have a cash company. We pay our bills immediately. We don't owe money. Customers pay us immediately. They do not owe us any money. And we don't have any other records to keep but the money that's coming in and the money that's going out. That's why in our videos, we will use just this window to record transactions. We know from previous videos that transactions are recorded into the general ledger. That means that after we record the transactions in the register window, QuickBooks will automatically copy those transactions to the appropriate account in the list of the chart of accounts that we created when we set up the file. After the transactions are recorded into the proper account, QuickBooks will make a special report that summarizes and organizes all of the accounts and shows you a list of the name of each account and the total remaining balance. The name of that report is called the trial balance. The trial balance is the first report that we will learn about. The trial balance shows the accumulated totals of all of the general ledger accounts. That means whenever you have a transaction, QuickBooks automatically posts and copies the transactions to the appropriate account in the chart of accounts. When that happens, the balance of the account changes. That means the face of the trial balance will change. Whenever you look at the trial balance, you'll see all of the accounts that we had put in the chart of accounts, but you will not only see their name, you will see the ending balance, which is the accumulated results of all the transactions. To prepare for our first transaction, we will open the register window from the main menu. Click Banking, Use Register, and then click OK. A window opens up that looks just like the checkbook register that our parents used to record their bank transactions in. And in the next video, we'll demonstrate how to record the transactions. But at the very same time that you're looking at the register, you should also look at the report that will show the results of your transactions. That's the trial balance. From the main menu, you should click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. It's good to position the trial balance and the register window in such a way that you can change from one to the other. Your screen will have much more room than mine. I'm recording the video, but on your screen you can keep them a little bit further apart or even put them next to each other. We're almost ready to go to the next video and start recording transactions. However, we must establish a rule that we will use for every future video in this class. Anytime we open a report in this class, we immediately change the date range of the report to all. This means we are able to see the results of all transactions regardless of date. The way to do that is to click in the top left of the report where it says dates. You get a pull down menu and you will scroll up and you will click on the all, which is the very top choice. Then you will see the date ranges change in the top and you will know that we have the results, or at least we're showing the results of all transactions regardless of date. When we go back to QuickBooks, you can see all reports in the top left have a date pull-down menu choice. You can click on it to get all of the different date choices and scroll all the way up to the top. This way you can click on the choice all and you can see the from and to disappear because now the trial balance is showing you the results of all transactions regardless of date. You should get in that habit every time you do an exercise in this course.